Greetings, sisters in Christ. What a blessed day it is. This has been on my mind recently. I wanted to share it with you. I wonder if you had seen the opening ceremony of the Commonwealth Games 2022. I'm inserting a short clip here.
For the Shards to work their magic again. Stella and the Dreamers used them to call for a moment of reflection and reconciliation. Now free and at peace, Bull of Birmingham really is the symbol for this Commonwealth Games.
He will, by the way, have a permanent place in the centre of Birmingham when these games end, and he will become the symbol of this theatrical and inspiring open ceremony.
Does this scene look oddly familiar? Does it remind you of something the Israelites did as soon as they crossed the Red Sea and when Moses had left them for just a few days? As much as the blessings of God are important and comforting, it's important to note how evil, cunning and wicked the devil is. He and his army of demons are always looking to steal, kill and destroy. If they can destroy our children, they can defeat the next generation of believers. Recently, my son Jordan wanted me to buy him a Beyblade. And the name of the Beyblade he wanted was called Lucius Endbringer. Lucius is another name for Lucifer. Why are so-called innocent children's toys being named after the devil? Our family, our kids are constantly under spiritual attack. The world we grew up in is not the same our children are growing up in. The word of God says the devil is prowling around like a lion looking to devour someone. Ladies, mothers, sisters, let's fight for our families. Let's fight these battles on our knees. I urge you to fast and pray for your families, your children, and your husbands. Go to your closets and close the door and pray to our Father in heaven, who I feel has extra keen ears for us mothers, because there's nothing more selfless than a mother's prayer for her children. Prayer is not the last thing that we can do. Our Christian walk isn't a stroll in the park. Instead, it's war on a battlefield. Let's remember Ephesians. And let's pray. Dear God, today we put on the full armor of God to guard our lives under attack. We put on the belt of truth to protect against lies and deception. We put on the breastplate of righteousness to protect our hearts from the temptations we battle. We put the gospel of peace on our feet, so we are ready to take your light wherever you send us today. We choose to walk in peace and freedom of your spirit and not be overcome with fear and anxious thoughts. We take up your shield of faith that will extinguish all darts from the evil one. We believe in your power to protect and choose to trust in you. We put on the helmet of salvation that covers our minds and thoughts, reminding us that we are children of the day and we are forgiven by God. And we are saved by Christ Jesus. We take up the sword of the Spirit, which has the power to demolish strongholds and sharper than any double-edged sword. And we ask for your help in remembering to put on your full armor every day. Forgive us, God, for the times we are unprepared and we try to fight and wrestle in our own strength. But thank you, Lord, that we are never fight alone. And you're constantly at work on our behalf, shielding, protecting, and strengthening us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Stay blessed, sisters.